Good morning, one and all. Welcome. Welcome to the other YouTube session from Pantech e-learning. So firstly, I would like to So welcome to our new session on workshop on embedded systems. Firstly, I would like to thank my Pantech e-learning team for this 2 days workshop in collaboration with Meenakshi College of Engineering. Now it was a great pleasure and pride that the Department of Electronic and Communication Engineering from Meenakshi College of Engineering, West KKR Nagar, Chennai, is collaborated with Pantech e-learning to conduct this operation. Now in this 2 days free workshop on embedded system, live knowledge, we would like to share the live knowledge sharing session by industry experts, knowledge sharing by industry experts on the last things and tending skills, as well as on tending technologies. This 2 days workshop session will be provided the participation certificate on embedded system. Sir, can't you say? Yes. Sorry for the lags and delays. I'm sorry for that. So here, without any lags, I'll start the PPT. So without wasting time, let's get into workshop on embedded systems. And once again, I'm thanking this Meenakshi College of Engineering, West KKR Nagar from Chennai. So this workshop will be conducted from 2 days, such as 17th May 2021 to 18th May 2021. So the timings are same, 11 a.m. to 12 a.m. So here I would like to thank the HOD of Stanley Radhal and the coordinator Vinala Priya. So thanks for giving this opportunity, ma'am. So I would like to start the embedded systems program now itself. Okay, so let's go on with embedded systems. So here our topic is embedded systems, right? So today I'll clear all the topics which are related to embedded systems with a clear explanation with practical examples. Okay, firstly, myself Mohan Sai, and I'm from Pantech Solutions. So now let's get into a session. So what is embedded systems? Before going to that, we should learn about what is system. Here we have two terms, right? What is embedded and what is system. Now let's go with system and let's end up with embedded, combines to form embedded system, right? Now what is system? A system, you know well about this thing, right? A system is a working step-by-step process. So simply we can define it as a step-by-step process. A system is a way of working or organizing, doing one or more tasks in a fixed plan or program with some certain set of rules. So that is what we call as system, right? So best examples are schools and colleges. So they work on one system, right, with some fixed plans as well as some certain rules. So that is what we call as system. So why we are using system in our core topic means here all the components such as sensors or whatever the controllers or whatever the outputs, monitors, something like that, works with certain rules, set of rules as well as some certain principles. Okay, so this is what we call, in this way we use this system to work on step by step process. Now what is embedded means aligning some components by side by side, side by side in the sense in a complete board, in a complete board or in a closed area, aligning some components, that is what we call as embedded. Embedded stands for that thing, and combines to form what is embedded system means we are working on that embedded devices, so-called particular devices which are arranged in a board with some certain operations like set of rules from step-by-step processor. That is what we call as embedded system. So the simple definition of embedded system is when in a system few or more components are combined to form a board. In that board they are talking with each other in the sense they are communicating with each other without any interface of human. That is what we call as embedded system. In a system where the components are communicating with each other without any interface of human, that is what we call as embedded system. A simple definition, right? Best example, there are so many examples in our daily life, so I'll go with the simple and basic example, that is nothing but while going to movie theaters or anything else, we'll see some automatic hand washers, right? So when you go to washroom or something like that, you can find that automatic water system. So what you do, you just raise your hand, that's it. So we get some output of water. So here you can observe that while we are pressing our hand sensor, that sensor is communicating with internal processor. Processor is nothing but a system which is controlling the entire system. So it talk with that and ask them to give some water. So that system know, like that controller know how to give and what to give, right? So here you have to observe one point. Here without any interface of human, we are not forcing anything and we are not asking anything. We just raised our hand and we are giving some input signal, that's it. So here that sensor and microcontroller is talking with each other and giving some output, right? So this is what we call as embedded system. Okay, so when systems are communicating with each other without any interface of human, that's it. Okay, now the basic block diagram of embedded system, what embedded systems consist of. So here it consists of sensors, processing units, actuators are nothing but output units. Okay, sensors are nothing but input units, processing unit is nothing but a main unit is nothing but a controlling unit. Okay, you got the idea, right? So here sensors are acts as input, processing units acts as brain, actuators are acts as output units. Okay, for example, sensors, you know, right? Whatever the object which is able to detect something in front of it or near to it, that is what we call as sensor, capacity of detecting something. Processing unit is nothing but acts as a processor, like brain. It can control the things as well as process the things. So actuators are nothing but monitors, whatever the outputs we are creating, printers or something like that. So depending on the system what we are using, the outputs will be changed, right? So these are the basic things for any embedded system. Now let's go with what is the difference between embedded systems and general purpose systems. Now as I mentioned here, clearly designed to some specific task for set of tasks. So embedded systems can only perform specific task. Best example, washing machine or oven or something like that. And general purpose general purpose systems are nothing but what we call, which can perform multiple tasks. Multiple tasks are nothing but like on our PC we can do multiple tasks, right? So that is what is the difference. The main difference, we can't cook with the help of washing machine, right? So the washing machine is only programmed for to wash the clothes, that's it. And the oven is only programmed for to cook food. Like that, it is specified for each task. So that is what embedded system stands for. And what is general purpose? It can perform multiple tasks. Okay, so not programmable by end users. So this is same, embedded systems are fixed, right? You can program that washing machine into what we call oven, right? and that oven into washing machine. We can't program at the end of the uses, okay? But in coming to general purpose computers, like computers or PCs, something like that, we can program according to our use, okay? That is what the difference. So here the next difference is, it consumes less power, it consumes high power. So you know that, right? It only performs one task and it doesn't require much power, and we are using all the smart things, right? It consumes less power depending on the system. Coming to general purpose systems, it consists of high power. As I said, it consumes more power in order to perform more tasks. So these are the main differences. And coming to the next difference, fixed time. For this, it consists of some fixed time. So that task should be performed in that particular time. It doesn't require any other times or something like that. Okay. So you got my point, right? Coming to washing machine, it only perform in that specified time only. So if the time is done, it will stop. It will start from the beginning. So we can't prolong that time, as well as we can't change that times. So according to our need, we can use the inbuilt fixed times, but we can't change the time if you want so. So coming to general purpose, we can use our PCs many times. Like many times in the sense, from morning to evening, that's your wish, if you give some power supply. Okay. Firstly, this is eco-friendly and it can perform on specified tasks. It costs more. So to perform one task, it costs more in PC. It costs less when you perform one system in embedded systems. Okay. So why we are considering embedded systems are, in these ages, it's important to develop one system in existing world. Okay. That is what India is lagging, where India is lagging. Okay. In China, coming to China, while don't feel I'm comparing with China, the best thing what China can do is, they can perform embedded systems in the age of 9 itself. So when they started giving birth or something like that, they start her son or his son to work on one embedded system. So they won't go with general purpose systems like big computers or robotics or something like that. They initially start with embedded system. So that is what we want in our India too. So if everyone started working on small embedded systems, like whatever the things, some specified tasks, that small things can change the entire world. So that is where India is lacking. So that's why we are learning all these things, and we are giving a much presentation about this in order to give some clarity, not for certifications and all. We are giving this knowledge in order to make you bright, not you bright, make India bright. So that is what our motto, okay? So gaining this knowledge is important. Apart from that, application is important. So I'll share this in 1 hour, that's okay. But you have to apply this 1 hour into 1 month or 1 year, that's your wish. But you have to develop one embedded system on your own. That is our final task, okay? So here, what we are thinking, apart from this, now let's go into embedded systems, our routine. Routine in the sense, our topic. So let's go with deep into this embedded systems. What are the types that present in our embedded system? So here the basic programs which requires two things. One is functional requirement and one is microcontrolling requirement, okay? Which is performed by functions as well as which is performed by microcontrollers. So I'll explain what is microcontroller and microprocessor, all the things in the next slide. So apart from that, here you can see what is the difference between functional requirements and microcontrolling requirements. In functional requirements, we use that for real time and to work alone and networking mobiles. So in this scenarios, we use this functional equipment. So coming to microcontrollers, where we use in small scale, medium scale, in the large scale itself. So small scales or large scales are nothing but which can perform one specified task. So medium scale is, let's consider small scale as clock. It can only display the time itself. So coming to medium scale, washing machine. It performs some task, more task, right? Like timer or something like that. It can perform more tasks. So that is what the difference. So what microcontroller can do, I'll explain those things. Before that, let's go with key components of embedded systems. So you know what is components? Components are nothing but a object which can use it to perform one task. So what are key components? Key components. So here the key components for embedded systems are processor. Processor is nothing but how I can explain this point is, it can perform a specified task, it can progress the task, like it can calculate the things and it can execute the thing. So here the execution process only takes place in processor itself. So we can call it as heart of embedded system. Okay, it performs as a heart. What heart can do? It can pump blood and it work according to it. It don't know anything how brain knows, right? So it only can perform the things, that's it, like heart. So that's why they call it as heart. Okay, so coming to memory units, it consists of some memory units. Why memory? Means in order to store the data we use that memory units, right? You know this point. So in order to store the data we need one unit, that is what we call as memory unit. It consists of different types of memory units, I'll explain that later. Before that, these two are the key components. In order to process something we need one heart to work on it, and in order to store the data we need one card to store the memory. So this is the process, key components in embedded system. You got it right? So coming to one human body, heart is important. So you can compare that heart with processor. In an embedded system, processor is the heart. And what is memory? Memory is nothing but we can store all these things in our brain, and brain consists of more parts, right? So one among that brain part is memory. So all this combines to form one brain, right? So that what we call as microcontroller. So before that I have to explain what is processor and all. Next we will go to microcontroller. Okay, you can consider this as a processor, as a child, not child, a brother. So that microcontroller as a big brother. Okay, so he is the one who makes the control of this heart as well as that that memory units, whatever the things in our. So it acts as a brain. So we call microcontroller as brain. Now let's get into microprocessor, the basic thing, the heart of embedded system. Okay, you can see the picture of processor here itself. Okay, for an embedded designer, the knowledge of microprocessor and microcontroller is must. So as I mentioned here, when you are going to embedded systems, you should learn about that heart as well as brain. Okay, microprocessor and microcontroller is important. So how important means, the in a human body, how brain and heart is important, like that these two are important in an embedded system. So that's why they are combining with that. So here we have, as I said, types of processors is there now. One is general purpose processors, which are nothing but microprocessor and microcontroller. These two are enough to perform one specified task. Okay, so in the many types are multiple processing systems, GPPs, as well as ASSP, application specified system processors. But in this scenario we only use a microprocessor or a microcontroller in order to perform one operation. So we'll go into these topics later on. We'll go to the next topics, which are ASSP and GPPs. Okay, now let's go with microprocessor. What is microprocessor? What is micro stands for? Firstly, what is micro means, it's a tiny particle. So when we are decreasing the sign, we are naming it in the form of units, micro, nano, pico, like that. So we are in the stage of microprocessing, micro units, right? Like the small things which are visible to our naked eyes. Now when we go to nanotechnology or something like that, so there will be nanoprocessors, all the things are there. Here the processing processor do the same job as what heart is doing. So whatever the thing for kids or for a big thing, like for kids or men's, whoever the are, heart is same for all, right? So the processor is same here. It only pumps the blood, right? It only performs the operations. Like that we can compare processor with heart. What micro, nano, pico stands for means the size of the chip. So the size of the entire processor. So whenever we are decreasing the size, we have to change the names into micro to nano, nano to pico. And the last one is quantum. Now the existing process what everyone is working is on quantum, right? So that is what we call. Okay, now let's get into what we call microprocessor. Microprocessor is a single chip semiconductor device, also which is a computer on the chip. So which acts as a computer on the chip, but not complete computer. So as they said, it's not it won't complete the entire computer. It only performs one part, like the processing unit, that's it. So for example, if you give a calculation of 2 plus 3, it instantaneously give 5, that's it. it don't know what is the value of 2 plus 3 as well as it won't store the values too. So for this storing purpose and for this understanding purpose, we designed microcontrollers, right? So what microcontrollers will do, whenever you give 2 plus 3, it will read the 2 plus 3 as well as it know, depending on the program what we have given, addition program, 2 plus 3 is 5, right? So it stores the 5 output too. Whenever you next time ask what is the value of 2 plus 3, so this microcontroller will go with the step 1, like it again processing from the beginning. So coming to microcontroller, it has initially some value, right? So we already read that thing. So it will give the output. Like that, microprocessor and microcontroller differ. So here there is, as I said, these two are brothers, but one is who is good at thinking and one is who had good at performing. That's it. So this is the difference I can say. So it consists of, as I said, it consists of CPU. In that CPU, you know, right, it consists of arithmetic and logical unit, ALU. So what it can do, it can perform the operations. In the reference of clock, timing, circuit, pulses, it will do some operations inside in it. So if you want to dig more, you can dig more. That's not a big deal. But coming to introduction, this is enough. ALU for arithmetic and logical unit, which can perform mathematical operations and whatever the operations we are giving. So with the help of some clock, pulse is inside thing, this all things are happened in a single chip. That's the important point. Apart from these things, what are it consists of? It consists of one memory unit. As I said, one is RAM and ROM. ROM stands for random. RAM stands for random access memory. ROM stands for read only memory. So as well as it consists of memory decoders and oscillators, the number of serials and parallel ports, so many things. But what processor will do means it only perform the operations. The next things are connected with internal buses. They are connected with the help of some buses like memories and whatever the things are, memory decoders, oscillators. So whatever the things are there. So here you can see some lines, right? If you aware of what is PCB, printed circuit boards, you can get all these things, because with the help of that copper lines only, this chip is connected to each and every interface. So each and every component is connected with the help of these lines only. So if you are if you don't know what is PCB means, just go through our channel. We have one PCB webinar on that. So in that I clearly explain all the things about what are the layers present inside the PCB and how they are connected among one another. So just go through it, you can get what are the connections and how these are connected internally. Okay, so here what are the various types of microprocessors which are present in our engaged life. Now these are the types which are designed by Intel, and these are the types which are designed by Motorola and Zillo. These three are the top top processors which are using daily life. But here before that I have to go with some introduction of Intel. So what is what Intel make changes means. So it developed it transistor. So you know the transistor, right? The access is switch. It can control the switches range, like connections range, like passing the electrons inside in it. So what transistor will do means that the thing. But they designed with the help of the first thing, who designed the microprocessor means you can clearly say it's an Intel. So Intel started the revolution of microprocessing. So they created all the things with the help of transistors, with the help of switchings. So as of fact, the phones you are using, the iOS phones, which consist of 2 billion transistors in a single microchip. So coming to Android phones, it may be less depending on the processor and depending on the communication. But coming to Intel, this is the only company which started working on transistors and the embedding things. And they designed one chip, it consists of billions of transistors to work on. So that's why we are working this much efficient, as well as the speed is this. Okay, now these are the processors. You know the deep you got some idea on processors, right? So I'll go with microcontrollers, then you can vary the difference between micro. So let's go with microcontroller. So what is microcontroller means, as I said, we can call it as system on chip. It's a combination of a processing unit, memory unit, input and output unit. So what are the difference mean? microprocessor only consists of CPU, central processing unit, one processing unit, that's it. So it only can perform ALU, arithmetic logical units. So coming to microcontroller, apart from processing memory, it can perform operations as well as it can store the operations with the help of memory, and it can give it can programmable for input and output too. So it know when to give the output and when to take the input. Like that, this is predefined. So that makes us make some changes in microcontroller. So what microcontroller includes means it has some integrated CPU, a memory unit. As I said, it consists of RAM, ROM, and latest version EPROM, flash memory. It consists of flash memory too. So it capable for input and output too. So this is the main thing what microcontroller stands in, number one. So what are the microcontrollers available in our daily life means, like in our trending technologies means. So firstly, microcontrollers is an idea of a student like us. So when he was in an internship, he started working on aligning of components. So so what he aligned, one controlling unit, one memory unit, as well as input output units which are suitable for that. So for in that technologies, he created one board, so called Arduino board. So for this Arduino board, he got support from Atmel Technologies. You know Atmel Technologies, right? So with designers chip, like the main unit, microcontrolling unit, which is designed for Arduino board. So Atmel Technologies given some initiation, ignited him, and all together they worked in 2006. They started one board, so called as Arduino board. So this makes a revolution for embedded system. So with the help of this board, we can perform one specified task. There is no need of designing and aligning all the components inside it because it was predefined. So as I said, this is the startup. Why I said Arduino board? Because we have so many boards, right? Why I used only Arduino means because it's a student, it created by the student like us. So it's not created by the engineer. Engineer means who is graduated. On his still graduation, he started working on one project to align something. So I want you guys to do at least one thing. If you start something, it will end up with a big things. So first start with this. So someone will talk about how I talked about that engineer, like student like us, which is who has designed this Arduino board. So someone will talk about this thing. So please get into it. If you are interested in, please go through this component. You start aligning your own components and give some output. So getting output is not important. So getting into it is important. So that is the matter what I want to convince. So apart from motivation, let's go with the next topic. What are the various types of microcontrollers? So these are the microcontrollers. As I said, Intel is the best one. So which can create some microcontrollers as well as microprocessors. So here the Intel, the main processors are 80 series, 8031, 8032, 8051, 8052. Like when you go with your BTech third year or something like that, you will find a chapter of microcontroller and microprocessor. In that, they will clearly mention these topics. So if you are aware of that, please learn the topics. It will be useful for the future. So don't think like what studies are doing in my life. So just go through it. It will teach you something. Okay. Next, main important microcontroller was designed by PIC. So it consists of 8-bit and 16-bit. These processors are the next level, as well as the final one, who is the motivator, Motorola. So Motorola is not the finest one, but it is in every session. So that is the motivation for all. So it's not the finest one, but it try to create each and everything, whether the microcontroller or microprocessor, whatever the things in it. So it will get into it. That is important, right? So that is what. Now let's go into the next session. What are microprocessor and microcontrollers? So let's start with what is microprocessor. And as I said, now let's compare yourself. What are the things I have said? So here the functioning blocks is ALU, registers, timers, and counter. These are inside in it. So apart from that, what it consists of means, what microcontroller consists of means, as I said, it consists of memory units, some ADC converters, DAC, ADC means analog to digital converters, as well as digital to analog converters. So you got an odd doubt of what is analog and what is digital. Analog signal means which is continuous in time. So the signal which is continuous in time, that is what we can call it as analog signal. So what is analog signal? Example, our voice signal. My voice signal is continuous in time, right? Next, what is digital signal? Which is discrete in times. So for example, ones and zeros. So when I talk to you in the form of ones and zeros, it can't be understandable, right? So that's why we are using analog to digital converters and digital to analog converters, which can convert vice versa things. Okay, that is the important thing what microcontroller consists of. It can take the analog input as well as digital input because it consists of two types of converters. So next important point, bit heading instruction is less, one or two types only. So here many types of bit headers instructions. So here what is bit header instructions are, which has nothing but in a microprocessor, it is only for one specified task. In the sense, a computer can do what it can perform, like the specified operations, that's it. So apart from this, what microcontroller can do means it can capable for many types of instructions. Like if you want to perform, if you want to change the operation of Arduino board from one form to another form, it's easy for you because it's an open source, as well as you can change that one. So coming to microcontroller processor, you can't change your computer, okay? But computer is a combination of microprocessor and microcontroller, but you can't change your computer. Computer is computer for you, that's it. But you can use that for specified tasks. So here, what is the difference means? You can rechange or resize this one. Here, microprocessor is can be resized and can be used only for the specified process, okay? As I said, it used for designing general purpose system, and this is used for microcontroller is for RSing, embedded systems, okay? Now, what is microcontroller family means? Examples. Like as I explained the types, right? So these are the things what are the microcontroller families. Here we use Atmel Technologies Atmega 32 page there na, we use that one in an Arduino board. Apart from that, we have PIC microcontrollers, microchip which is designed by PIC, 8051 which is designed by Intel, and 68H12 which is designed by Motorola. You got it right? These are the four types of microcontroller families. So what are the softwares used? So this is the basic thing for you, because for each and every electronic device, we can't talk into that electrical language. Electrical language is nothing but ones and zeros, right? So for this interface, we need one source code. Source code is nothing but which is understandable by the user with the help of with computer. But you can speak with that computer with the help of, you can give some instructions, like, right? With the help of these many languages, we have some C, C++, Assembly, Java, Python, whatever the languages we have, we can talk with that. We can give some instructions with that. But inside that thing, that source code will be converted. We have some compilers. We have something. So with the help of that language is converted into machine language. And you can write that machine language, but it's very hard to write that machine language because everything is created by human. But that machine language was generated with the help of this compilers and simulators. But we can write in the form of source code. That source code will be converted into machine language, and this machine language in the form of ones and zeros, right? And that ones and zeros will be understandable by the each and every chip, whatever the chip we are using. We can use that one. Here, what are the communications we have? Communication in the sense, in how many ways we can connect with that interface from one to another. We have serial communications, SCI, and synchronous serial communications. In this, so many things are there, like I2C or SPI protocols. So what are these means? It's a kind of, what is protocol means? It's a step-by-step alignment. What MSS consists of? It consists of some information, right, in the form of step-by-step processor, right? Like that, for each and every communication interface, we consist of some step-by-step rules as well as step by step lines. So that is what they call as protocols. So they follow that protocols in order for communication. Okay, that is the main thing. So apart from that, what are the systems we are used for this? We use some network systems and timer systems, discrete IO. So these are the main examples. If you want to make a screenshot, you can screenshot now itself. So because these are important, if you dig each and everything, you can find 1 month. You can seriously spend 1 month for each and everything. Okay, so that is important. So apart from this thing, what is a communication means? As I said, in order to connect with one to another, we need some language or source code or some kind of rules in order to follow that one. In order to execute one purpose, we need kind of rules, right? So that rules are will be followed in the form of communication. So we use in our daily life serial communication. Why serial communication means? Serial communication requires less number of wires. Wires are nothing but, so coming to parallel communication, what is parallel communication? It executes all the values at a time. Like if you are executing 4-bit means, it requires 4 lines, 1 ground line. So we require 5 lines in order to transmit 1 4-bit signal. 4-bit signal is nothing but, if you want to transmit the 2, what is the binary code of 2? 0010, right? So we required 4 lines for that. So coming to serial communication, it only requires 1 line, and that 1 line will be that particular number will be transmitted in the form of 1 line, like 0010. So with the help of address, it won't mix with one another. So it takes some time in a serial communication, but what is the best thing is it requires less efficiency. Yes, less efficiency in the sense less amount money. Okay, apart from that, what are the applications we are working on? So what we can do with embedded systems means, so here I'll explain one basic thing, but you should go with these many applications. So what are the applications? Householding applications, Arduino player, cellular telephones, engine controlling in automation and automobiles, calculator, video games, aircraft, medical equipment, and defensive systems. So these many applications are there for embedded systems. You got it right. So what we are familiar with? We are familiar with video games. You can create video games with the help of these applications. So that is your wish. So if you want to create one game, you can go on with this embedded systems. Just take any of this board where I shown different types of families, right? So in that you can pick any of the board. Now I'll go with Arduino board. You can take the Arduino board too, but for gaming it requires more and more, right? For that I think you have to use Raspberry Pi. So that's a kind of embedded system which is connected to internet. We can call it as IoT thing. But here, what are the applications and why means, we use this for to work on in one certain system. Okay, one certain specific program. So try with the calculator, it's your wish. So completely your wish. But what is the main thing is, main motto is to work on at least one thing. So that is important. So just go on with one thing, whatever the things you have. But I'll go with Arduino. You just learn all the things about Arduino and do research on the things. So whatever I explained is a part in ocean, but ocean is limitless. So you have to work like that. So here I explained one way to go to ocean. So you have to find more paths to create one ocean. So that is our main motto. So here I'll go with Arduino. Now what is Arduino means? Introduction to Arduino board. Arduino board, as I said, it was designed like a student like us. Okay, that is important. So he created all these things with the help of one technology. Atmel Technologies, they have grabbed him. That's not a big deal. So when you have talent, everyone comes to you. That is important. So what is introduction for Arduino board means? Arduino board is an open source electronic platform based on easy to use hardware and software systems. So what is open source means? You can change this, you can edit this board itself. So whatever the task you have, whatever the performances you have, so you can change all the things according to your need. So that is the best thing you have in that embedded systems. So what is Arduino board? What Arduino board can do means, you can use this as a one microcontroller to perform one specified task. If you want to edit that one, you can easily edit with the help of one software. We named it as Arduino software, Arduino IDE. So you can edit with the help of that software. So before that, I'll explain the components it presents of and what is the board, what is the applications for this. So Arduino board consists of USB port. This is what we call as USB port. And why USB port means, in order to dump the code from our PC to board, we need one external source, right? So here we won't use any external source like one hard disk or something like that. We just need one cable, USB cable. If you connect that USB cable, the entire code will be dumped. Okay, here it consists of one power supply. If you are done with coding, dumping the code, so there is no need of dumping many times. So just need one time. It consists of, as I said, it consists of microprocessor and microcontrollers, right? The entire thing will be stay saved in microcontroller itself. So it consists of one power supply, power port. Why power port means, if you are done with your dumping code, there is no need of use of laptop for next time. So if you want to execute the next thing, you can use that power supply in order to give the entire board work on. Work on means, for any electronic device, it requires some power supply, right? So yeah, if you are not connected to laptop, the best thing in USB port means, apart from dumping the code, it acts as a power supply. So if you are done with code, you don't want laptop, you want to port this board from one to any areas or something like that means, any areas or something like that means you can port this one with the help of power supply. If you give power supply of 5 volts, that's enough to work with it. So the limit of this is 20 volts. So if you exceeded the 20 volts limit, the board will be blasted. So keep it in mind. So you have to use 5 volts adapter, that's it. Okay, so that's important. Apart from that, what are the components aligned into it? USB port, power supply, and next, analog and digital pins. So what are analog and digital pins? As I said, analog are continuous in time. So whenever you are giving some analog inputs, you have to use these 6 pins. It consists of A0 to A5, right? You have to use these 6 pins. So that is important. And apart from that, it consists of 14 digital pins. So when you are giving some discrete signal, you can use this one. So discrete in nature means light or power supply. So you can use that one. And if you are giving some voice sensors or voice signal, you have to use these pins. So which is for analog, these pins, digital, these pins. So that's important. So here, depending on the program, we can change the pins. So here that pins is not important. Here the thing what we can use is important. So if we can give analog as well as digital. Now you know these pins, right? What is reset pin is nothing but, if you are done with your program but you want to execute one time, so there is no need of dumping the code again in this. The best part in this is, it consists of one reset pin. You can execute, if you click that one, it will start from the beginning. So wherever you are, if you are stuck with that one, so you can just click this button and it will start from the beginning. So you can feel this one. So if you have this in our phone, mobile phone itself, so whenever our phone is hanged, you can use this button. So whenever you use reset button, so it will start from the beginning. So if you upload this one into our mobile phone, it will be more helpful, because few phones will hang in the middle, right? We got some frustration. So here we don't need to worry about that one. If you click this one, it will start from the beginning. So it won't erase the data, it will start from the beginning, that's it. So so dumping one time is enough to store the data. If you dump the next code, until then it will store the code. Okay, that's important. So here let's go with the few components what I left. It consists of, as I said, it consists of one microcontroller, which is designed by Atmega 328 Atmel Technologies, named it as Atmega 328p. Why 328 means, it consists of 3 ports and 28 pins. So that's why they named it as Atmega 328p. okay, P stands for ports. Okay, Atmega 328p, this microcontroller consists of one CPU inside in it. Explain now what it consists of. CPU, memory unit, input output unit. So all these things are operated by this chip only. So with the help of these lines, copper lines inside this, if you learn heard about PCB, so these lines are connected to each and every component. You can clearly see, right? So these things are connected to each and every component. So that's important. So apart from that, what is Arduino means? This is Arduino for you. It's an open source electronic platform. There is nothing inside in it. So you can go with all the things, whatever the things you have in internet. So I explained the short explanation of Arduino board. You can use that one as a simple board which can perform one operation. So if you have this one, you can do one operation automatically. So that's important. So if you want to wash your hand, wash your clothes, like a sanitizer or something like that, whenever you inserted your hand, it should pull some what we call sanitizer or something like that means. So for this, it needs some controller, right? So you are giving some input with your hand, but it should process the thing to give some output as sanitizer, right? For this, we need one brain. So for every system, we need one brain, right? And we call that brain as Arduino board, okay? It can perform one specified task which is programmed by human itself. So what Arduino board consists of? So what are the specifications? Firstly, so the operating voltage will be 5 volts. As I said, it shouldn't exceed 20 volts. The operating voltage 5 volts is enough. And if you are giving some input voltage, as I said, the recommended voltage will be 7 to 12 volts. Okay, if you are connecting to 9 volts power supply battery, that's enough, that's nice. So the thing is, you shouldn't exceed 20 volts. And here the best thing is, you don't need to buy all these things online. Like, we are facing some lockdown, right? So you may think of how to execute all these things practically. We have one software, so called Tinkercad, so we can execute all these things virtually. So that's the main part. I'll explain how to install Tinkercad, and I'll show how to do at least one program with the help of Tinkercad. Okay, don't worry about that, we'll go through it. Before that, you should be aware of what is Arduino and all. Next, just go with what are the types we have, like what are the components and what are the specifications we have. So as I said, voltage is done. So as I said, digital inputs of 14, among them 6 are PWM pins. PWM pins are nothing but pulse width modulation pins. How you can identify that one means, PWM pin separately consist of some arrow mark inside in it. So we can use that pins as PWM pins. Why? How to use means, in order to get some analog output in a digital signal, we use these pins. You got it right? These 14 pins are digital in nature, but these 6 PWM pins has analog output nature. So that is important. So if you want to get output from these pins, these 6 pins you can use as analog output. Analog output is nothing but ones and zeros in a continuous form. 0 volt, 5 volt, 0 volt, 5 volt, like that. If you want to, best example is, in your mobile phone you are decreasing some brightness, right? So how it is decreasing means, so each and every LED is connected to this PWM pin. So whenever you are controlling that, decreasing that one, the on time will be decreased. Like, if you are keeping that into 30%, the on time will be 30% and the off time will be 70%. So on an average, you got an output of 30% decreasing brightness. So if you want to use 100 brightness, you'll increase the on time to 100%, right? So that is with the help of these pins only, we can control that one. If you want to control in between the one, you have to use these pins. So that's why they specified separate pins for this analog output, okay? And apart from that, it consists of 6 analog inputs. Analog inputs as nothing but a voice control inputs or something like that, whatever the input you are giving, which is analog in time. So you can use these pins, okay? And apart from that, it consists of DC current, voltage 40 amperes. So there is no need of mentioning, it consists of 3 volt pin, which is a capacity of 50 milliampere. And it consists of flash memory. As I said, why flash memory means, what is RAM, you know, right? RAM is random access memory. If any power supply is gone, the entire program will be erased. So in order to eradicate that one, here they introduced EEPROM. EEPROM is nothing but read-only memory, which can store that memory until you erase that one. So you can see RAM of 2 KB and EEPROM of 1 KB. Here, what flash memory differs means, it is a non-volatile memory. So when we use flash memory in order to store all the data. But what is the difference between EEPROM and flash memory means, it is consists of high data, 32 KB, and coming to EEPROM, it consists of 1 KB data. So that's it. You got it right, the difference. So these two are same, which are non-volatile memories. We can't erase the data, but this it consists of high storage and this consists of somewhat less storage. That's it. But we can change these things according to our budget. So if you are investing 10,000 or 20,000 to this software or this to design this particular board, you can increase this RAM and ROM too. Okay, that's not a big deal. Apart from that, the inbuilt what they have given, like Arduino board is consist of 600 to 700 in nature. Now the supplies, the demand is high because the supply was stopped right from China. But why we are exporting from China or some, it was purely made in Italy, but we export from China because it's as I said, there are more engineers compared to India. So if you change this one, if you assemble this one, we won't get from China, we only take from you. So that is important. So not from you, not from our side. So everyone will try to increase their country, either India or China or America or whatever the country. So we don't have that one, so we are taking from others. That's it. So now let's go into the last one, what we remind, clock speed. Clock speed is nothing but it generates clock pulses. So with the speed of 16 megahertz, in your number form, it can generate 16 million clock pulse in 1 second. So that is in our basic language, 16 million clock pulse in one second. So in each clock pulse, it can perform one specified operation. Operation is in the sense, any addition or subtraction, whatever the things we give, it can perform in each clock pulse. Okay, that is important. So that's why we are getting this much speed in order to work on. So apart from that, this is the inside schematic diagram for Atmega 328P, what are the chips it consists of, which is designed by Atmel Technologies. Okay, you can clearly see it consists of flash, RAM, EEPROM and timers, counters, central processing unit, CPU, and these are the senior input outputs, we give some input outputs, right? So we connect all these things, inside in it. So you won't find all these things, you only find this chip. So in this chip, all these connections are inscribed inside in it. You got it right? In this chip, all these things are there. Whatever the central processing unit, your T-pins, whatever the things you have, all these parts are inside in it. So these are the pin configuration. If you want to go through it, you can go through it and make a screenshot. And if you want to do a project on this specified topic, you just go through all these pins. If you want to connect any other component to this component, we have to use these pins wisely. So I'll explain that in our further slides. Don't worry about that, I have that slides too. So apart from that, we are done with Arduino board introduction. You know, you have some idea of what is Arduino. So apart from that, what is the software used for Arduino board? Arduino board is nothing but, for this board, we need some language, right? As I said, for each and every electronic component or electronic device, it requires one language to understand. Understand in the sense to work on. Whatever the instructions we are giving, if you speak in Telugu or English, it won't understand. If you speak in the proper language, so-called for Arduino, there is an Arduino IDE. So with the help of C and C++, they designed this language. You can use that language to give some instruction. So this is the basic IDE view. How to install this one means, go to Chrome itself. So you can find Arduino.cc. So when you search with Arduino.cc, if you don't mind, I'll do that one for you. So here, Arduino.cc. So when you search with this, you will get an interface of Arduino official site. My net is slow, don't worry, sorry for that. So here you can see, right, this is the interface of Arduino IDE. Now, so if you are done with that, let's go to software session. So you have to type Arduino.cc. So when you go to software session, you can get an interface like this. So when you get this one, here you can clearly see download options. So if you click this one, Windows and higher, Windows 7 and newer, if you are new to Windows 7 and newer, so you click that one, and next you have to click just download. That's it. So here you can clearly see the Arduino is started. Okay, here I don't require Arduino software because I have that Arduino software. I wanted to show you, I was here. So apart from that, the basic idea will be look like this. Okay, you have to click just download, you're done, right? So if you are done with that, the interface will be like this. So the first session will be started like this. Here in this you can consist, when if you go to file session, you consist of some examples. You can go to the examples and you can do. So if you are aware some basic language on C, you can get all these things. But here the basic part of explanation is here, you can clearly see, right? So please look into it. So it consists of one bar. Here you can see, right? One bar. That bar will be like this. So as I mentioned, A to verify the entire code. So if any errors are there, this will look to it. So if you click this button, so if any errors are there, it will display at the bottom of the code. So if you want to execute this code, like if you want to dump this code to board, means you have to click this B option is there, na? This they name it as upload button. You have to click this button. If you click that button, automatically the entire code will be uploaded to the board itself. So here you can save and you can whatever the things you have. These two are not that much things you have to upload and you have to download whatever the things you have. So apart from that, what is the important thing is it consists of serial monitor. So there is no need of waiting for output which is connected to your device. You can clearly see the values here itself. What are the output things you have? If you are connected to the board, then only the serial monitor will work. So if you are not connected to the board, you are done with execution, means it will display you are not connected to the port itself. So that's it. So if any wrong messages are there, so the entire thing will be look like this. So if you are done uploading, means it will look like this. It's a bit size. So whatever the processing size is done, so it will display the size. It's a basic thing for each and every program. Apart from that, if you are done with any wrong things, wrong steps, the board will be displayed like this. Yes, in a red color. In a red color, it will display wrong board selection. So if you are selected wrong board, it will show that one. If you are not selected the ports, you are display like this. So I'll show how to select the ports and all. Don't worry about that. Here, if you are done with coding, if you have some code in your hands, so if you are done with verifications, there is no bugs inside in it. That's a good part. So apart from that, what is the mandatory step to dump the code? So firstly, you have to go to tool session, and firstly you have to select the board. Here they selected board, right? So now we are dealing with Arduino Uno, right? You have to select this board, Arduino Uno. Next, you have to go to serial port. What is the port you have connected? You have connected to one serial port, right? To computer. Serial port is nothing but you connected to one CPU unit, right? Control, like what is the thing? USB port, right? So you have to connect the latest one. COM1 is an inbuilt one, but what is the thing you have connected latestly, it will display here itself. You have to select these two things. So whenever you have selected these two things, then only you have to upload the code with the help of this button. Okay, so if you are not connected to that board, if you are not these things before, the display, the output will be like this. So as I said, the output will be displayed here. You are connected to wrong board or you are connected to wrong serial. So here the serial board is important. You have to connect these two things. These are mandatory. And now go through the programming. So what are the things you have in the programming? So whenever you started with this Arduino board, the interface will be like this. You can see one serial setup and void loop. Sorry, void setup and void loop. So what is void setup and void loop? Before going to that, you should aware of the basic language in our session C. Like in our daily life, C is basic language, right? We started with that. So if you use C language, in that C language we consist of int main, right? Like that, what int main stands for, we have to inscribe all the functions inside in it. So like that, here we consist of two things. One is void setup and void loop. Int for integers, void is for separate string. Okay, you got it right. So apart from that, void, in this void setup, what you can do, void setup is to execute one command for one time. Okay, void loop for to execute those commands for many times. So it execute, it's an infinite loop, right? So it will execute until you stop the program. So that is void setup. So if you are taking any input or any output, if you are to execute something, we need some functions, right? So for that functions you have to write in void setup, and the continuous loop things you have to write in void loop. Okay, if you write all the program in void setup itself, it will execute, that's not a big deal, but it only execute for one time. If you want to loop that thing, you have to use void loop. That is important. So as I said, this is the programming structure. Arduino can divide it in three main parts: structure, variables and functions. So values are nothing but variables and construct. What are the things you have to inscribe in that void setup? What are the functions you have to call that one? So I'll explain that one clearly in the next slides, don't worry. So here, what are the void setup for and void loop is for? If you want to take a screenshot, you can take that one. So void setup function is called when a sketch start. So sketch is nothing but the entire programming starts. So if you want to initialize, in this you what you have to initialize? Pin mode. So we are using some pins, right? So what coding means, we are describing that pins in the form of their language. Like we have connected one sensor to that board, that's okay, but we have to describe that thing in their language. Like if you did that thing in English or Telugu, it won't understand that language, right? So you have to inscribe in this language, like that what we call as pin mode. You have to describe that pin. So I am using third pin as output, like that. Not you should mention this prepositions like I or like that. So pin mode you have to mention pin mode 13 as output, that as not you have to give comma. I'll show that one in a program, don't worry. But you have to use this language, specified steps are there, na? You have to use. So you have to use, you can start libraries. If you want to work on some library, you have to call in this initial setup only. So if you are using that NumPy or something like that, you have to use. So whatever the libraries you have, you can use in this session only, in this setup only. Okay, and what is the setup? As I said, it only can perform one time. It only run one time until you end the power up of Arduino board. So ippudu varaku, sorry, at the end, until the end, it will work onto it. Okay, it only execute one time. So what void loop means, it's a complete different thing, quite opposite thing. Void loop execute until you active the next control. Next control, if you given the next control, until that one it will execute. So apart from that, void loop is for to perform any operation multiple times, like repeated times. If you want to repeat the operation many times, you have to use the entire code in void loop itself. So for this, the basic things are, so if you want to give if you want to set up the pins, the basic terms are input. You have to use that in capital, input or output. If you want to describe any pin, so you have to, like, this is the basic syntax for this one. So if you want to describe pin mode, so here in pin mode, the syntax will be M should be capital. Why M should be capital means, in this language, if you are combining two words, you have to write the second word first letter should be capital. That is the rule. Okay, if you describe this M with small m, it won't take this value. Okay, it will describe this as an error. So you have to, if you are describing some inputs, you have to use this model, pin mode. So what is the pin? So firstly, let's consider with an example. Let's go with that example. I want to blink an LED light. So LED is, you know, right, LED, small LED light. For LED light, it consists of two ports. One is positive port and negative port. So negative port should be connected to ground. Here we consist of some ground ports, right? You can connect whatever the things you have with the help of jumper wires or whatever the things you have. So here you can clearly see, I need one digital port and one ground port, right? Here there are side by side. So yeah, you can connect here itself, one ground and one positive port to this data pin. So this we call it as data pins, right? Input data pins, right? So you can connect. Why we are connecting? We can connect directly 5 volts, then automatically that light will on continuously. Here I want to control that light to on and off, to on and off, like that. So if you want to run that light continuously, means here I can connect directly, I can give 5 volts as well as ground. Here, before giving to power supply, you have to connect one resistor, right? So that's important. So here we won't use that one, but that is important. So I'll show that one in serial simulation. Like we use one software, right? In that software, we use that one in Tinkercad. Don't worry about that. But this is the terms what I show there, or what I'll explain there. In pin mode, what I have to display. Here I'm taking 13th LED, 13th pin. So I have to display 13th mode as output. I want the LED to blink, right? Like to on, and off. I am controlling that LED. So I want to keep that as on, like an output. If you are taking something from that outer components, means you have to name it as input. You are giving outside, right? You are displaying something from the board, that is output, right? So you have to mention output 13 as output. So what is digital write means? Here we are using digital pins, right? So for that, the basic syntax is digital. Write means we are, if you like, let's consider our brain. If you are writing something, what you are doing, you are giving some output from brain to notebook. Read means you are reading from that book to our brain. So here brain is Arduino board, that book is LED light. So here we are giving from Arduino board to light, that is write. If you are reading from that entire thing, whatever the output we have, LED light or something, you have to use digital read. So here we have to write that one. So here we are displaying something from the board, right? So we have to use that 13th pin value. Value is nothing but you want to on or off. In this language, on means high, low means off. So here I want firstly to on, 13 to on. And pin mode, what the next one? Here in I'll give some delay of one second. So after that, what I'll write? Digital write. What I'll write? Pin mode 13 as low. Low means off. So I'll write all these things in a loop. So what we'll do after that 1 minute, 1 second delay, it will again go with digital write 1 minute as high and go to low, high, low. Like that, it continuously start blinking. So that's it. That's the output what we have to obtain in a blinking process. So here, as I said, delay, we use some delay, right? So what delay means, in this language, the delay is in milliseconds. There is no need of mentioning MS here itself. If you use the number 100 or 1000, it will consider that as a milliseconds. Okay, so here you can use that syntax, so called delay microseconds, US, which is tiny part for us. So we only use delay in the form of this one. So here what we can do means we can control the output. The output means, as I said, here we can control the time. In this time, if you give it some delay, means it will give to rest. So whenever the delay is done, it will again start from one. So that's it. Why delay means wherever it was. So if it get a time of delay, in that time it will stop working and it will wait for the time to run. So the counter will be on, so it will count for 1 second. After that, it automatically sends a signal of one. So the next signal, either it is one or zero, that's our wish, but that is the thing. So here digital and analog, as I said, this is a clear explanation of digital and analog. Here digital has two values, on and off. Here and analog has many infinite values. For digital, it only has one and zeros. For analog, as I said, it's a continuous in time rate. We can describe that one and zero, it will be continuous, either maybe high or low, whatever the things it have, it will continue according to it. Computer really, for here, the basic thing what I have to explain is, in this session, analog and digital slide, we only use digital transmission in entire systems. Okay, we only use digital transmissions. We won't use this analog transmissions in our daily life. So wherever the system and whoever the one dealing with this transmission of data will only use digital signals. Why digital signals? Means digital signals are less catch up to noise. So worst things of analog, so then you can describe digital noise, digital things. So here analog signal is easy to catch up with noise. So analog signal can catch up noise easily. Best example, while we are recording some songs or something like that, if you listen that same noise again to that record again, you can clearly find the disturbance as well as your voice is changed, right? So that is what noise stands for. So here it will catch up the noise while we are transmitting from our mouth to microphone. So because air is free, it is in air, so whenever we are transmitting some signal, the noise will be added. So that is the main thing. So in order to eradicate that one, apart from that, this analog signal need more things to transmit from one to another. Like it's a continuous signal, it may be catch up noise in between the transmission too. So that's why we won't use analog signal. The only reason is it can catch up high noise in less time. So coming to digital signal, why we use this one means it won't catch up any noise, because it only either it has 0 or 1. Maybe it catch some noise, but it is negligible. We won't read that one. So what a digital will do means it is easy to transmit. For transmission, we just need 1s and zeros, right? So we'll keep address for each and every 1s and zeros. So you make out a doubt of why we can't give address to analog. Because we can't break that analog signal to give some address, because it is continuous and time. If you break that signal, you can find some space in that continuous signal like that. So we can't give address in between that. We can give address for the whole thing, like from 1 to 100. For that we can give analog signal address. But if you do like that, if any mistake happened in the form of combination of one call to another, so we have to wait for the 100th second. So coming to digital signal, here for each and every second or for each and every bit, it consists of one digital address. So with that address, we can easily eradicate that mistake. So if any mistake done, we can eradicate in the next step itself, because it consists of another address, right? So if you done the first one done with the wrong address, the second one will go to the right address, because it only follows its unique address. So that's why we are using digital signal in nature. This is the main point. So let's go with our first program, whatever we have. So I would like to show that one. In a software, we call it as Thinkercad. Thinkercad. Here you can clearly see, right? Thinkercad. So if you open this one, the display will be like this. Let's end up this session with this Thinkercad. So here, when you are new to this, you have to they'll ask you to sign in. Okay, so firstly they'll ask you to sign in. So firstly what they will ask means they'll ask you to sign in. So here you can go through the Google account. You can here I started with my account Hyderabad Embedded. So here why I using this account means, here I am already designed few circuits for you in order to show the output clearly with less time. So here our main motto is to design something, right? Regarding that Arduino board, right? You can go to the circuit session. So when you go to the circuit session, you can find a object like this, a option like this, so called create new circuit. You can go through that. So if you click that one, you can create that one new session. So that's apart from that, here I created a session for you previously. So if you click that one, that is nothing but a name. So here I want to make some edits here itself. So just go through the Thinkercad, install. There is no need of installing anything. You just need to start the program itself. So whenever you started, if you are new, here you can search the components. Okay, if you are opening new one, you can search the components here itself. Okay, here what I want, Arduino. Here you can see, right, Arduino. So here Arduino R3, you have to drag that one like this and that's it. So it will appear to you. So whenever you drag that one here, I don't need this one, right? So I have to delete this one because I already have Arduino board which is using. So I'll replace this one. I don't want this one. So here I deleted the previous one. Before that, I'm done with Arduino board, right? Now how to take that LED means you can search whatever the components you have. So as I said now, in this lockdown, it's hard to buy these components outside. So just you can order in Amazon Prime or something like that. But before that, practice in this Tinkercad software. So why practice means you can get all these things while coming to real time. You have to drag that one. So I'll show how to make connections here itself. Don't worry. So if you take in this one, it will be look like this. You have to when you go to that line here, cathode and anode, you got it right. So you have to connect these lines wisely. Okay, here you can find, right? So here I connected anode, give me a minute, I'll delete these things. Sorry, my PC is slow. So here you can clearly see when I go to this LED light, it will clearly show cathode, right, and anode. You know, cathode means negative, anode means positive. As I said, you have to drag that line. When you touch that one, you have to drag according to it. Okay, there is no need of worrying. Whenever you go to that port, it will clearly show that ground. That's it. You have to connect that ground. So however you connected, that's your wish. It won't mix with, because it's a software, right? It won't mix with that one. So you have to use any of this LED pin. So as I said, here I'm connecting to two pins. Okay, 13 and 14. So like that you have to connect. In order to show you, I did these things, but this is the nice clear dragging point, right? So you have to drag, if you want some clarity, you have to drag this one. So what's next? You are done with connections. Here you have to code what I explained. So here you have to create wired setup. As I explained, you have to use this line and you have to describe the pin mode. As I said, you have to describe the pin mode. What is that pin mode? So you have to describe this ninth LED. I want that as an output. So here I described each and everything, right? So here after that, we are using only one port, right? So you are done. So what I want continuous form. What I want here, I want that LED to go high and like on and off continuously. So what I'm writing. So in digital writing, I'm using that 9th LED as high first. After that delay of one second, as I said, now it's in milliseconds, 1000 milliseconds. After that, 9 should be 1000 seconds delay. It should work on and off. Let's simulate with this. If you have any errors, it will display right here itself. So if you click that simulation button, you can clearly see, right, this light is on and off. Here it's saying you have to connect one resistor. That's not a big deal, but coming to real session, you have to connect one resistor. Okay, but here you can clearly see, right, this light is on and off. Now let's change the program with the timer. So we want to play that one, right? That's our motto. Now let's do this with 5 milliseconds. Like 5 milliseconds is very fast. Or let's go with 500 milliseconds, like 0.5 seconds. Let's see what happened. Okay, so like that, you can do whatever the things you have. Okay, you can write this code or you can find the source code in the Arduino board itself. So here you can clearly see, right, on and off, what are the things that are happening. You can execute this in virtually in Tinkercad. That's important. So that is the things what I want to explain. So if you want to stop simulation, you can stop. So here I think you are aware of what are the things you have to create in this Tinkercad. Now so when you go to backside here, I mentioned so many, just give me some time. So here you can see I developed so many circuits. Like that you can develop many circuits depending on the code equipment. So here there are so many circuits, right? Here one is LED light blinking, and one is buzzer with the help of ultrasonic sensor. I'll explain the sensor things later. before that, let's go with, we are done with LED blinking, right? Now, let's go with the sensors. So as I said, we consist of many sensors, right? So as I said, this is the basic example for LED code blinking. You can copy that, or we'll provide the source code. Here are the connections. As I explained, you can use this switch. So as I said, you have to connect one resistor, right? So Y button means if you want to on it off, they're controlling with button. But here we are programming with the Arduino board, right? There is no need of doing all these things. And this is 7 segment. 7 segment display is nothing but we are using some LCD displays, right? So the format will be like this. So the entire format will be like this. So if you want to display on and off, you have to display according to these numbers. So inside the 7 segment, inside the LED light, you can see this in everywhere. So each and everything is divided in this many parts, A, B, C, D, up to F, okay? So when you on these things, so according to this program, the entire thing will work. In order to show something, I was displayed this project. But so see, it is displayed initially for each and everything. So here you can clearly see. So if you want that LEDs, you have to blink according to this code. If you want to on that one, so according to this code, one, like B and C should be on. Like that, you have to code each and everything. You can clearly see, right, the code here itself. So this is the next process thing. Don't worry about this. This is somewhat complicated. First, go through the basic examples of Arduino board, what I have shown before. So you can do all these things. You have to connect this thing with the help of one LCD display. So I'll show that one in the next sessions. Sensors are the input units for each and every embedded system. So sensors, what sensors can do? It can detect the 5 sensing objects what human can do. It can smell, it can taste, it can see, and it can hear. Like that, we have 5 sensor organs, right? So referring on that 5 sensing organs, they developed these sensors according to it. But we divided that sensors into many ways according to our use. But top 5 are this one, which are used by human as in, with the reference of human senses, they developed these sensors. That's important. So I'll end up with this sensor, one sensor uses. I'll show that one demo with the help of Tinkercad. So we'll end up this session, don't worry, okay? So what are analog sensors and digital sensors? Also, which one a sensor can give continuous output, that's a analog sensor. So when a sensor can give digital output, discrete in time means once in a second or once in a minute, like that. So not a continuous output, that is what we call as digital sensor. So whatever the sensor, this IR sensor, which is called as infrared radar sensor, which is a discrete in time, it will only show discrete things. That's it. So this is IR sensor for you. So you can observe the basic thing. It consists of 3 ports, right? One is ground, VCC, output port. So I'll explain all the sensors in our next class. Sorry for keeping in you in this situation, like I'm not explaining all the things right about sensors. So if I explain all these things now itself, we get some more, right? So I would like to end up this session with the sensors part itself. So I'll continue in the next session, like tomorrow. In that session, we'll continue the sensors and execution of sensors with Tinkercad. And I'll come up with the huge explanations and applications. I have so many things to prepare, like to prepare in the sense to show you. Like I'll explain the coding, and I'll go with, we'll end up that session with this 7 segment display, okay? So if you have enough time in your home, please do research on these things what I explained before, like micro sensor, microcontrollers and microprocessors and all the things. And before that, thanks for joining in this session, and thanks for your patience. You are still from 1 hour, right? So those who are from the beginning of the session, thanks for your patience and all. So those who are joined in the middle, thanks for you guys too. And whoever listened to this session, use this session wisely. And once again, I'm thanking my department, which is Pantex Solutions, and the Department of Electronic Communication Engineering, who given this opportunity. So I would like to thank them wholeheartedly. So I'll reduce all these mistakes in tomorrow session. I'll come with a new boost as well as new applications. We'll start that with a valuable session. Don't worry about that. So thanks for joining. If you have any doubts, please let me know. I'll answer the session. I'll answer the questions. It's too lag, right? So if you have any questions, please let me know. I'll answer that one. Before that, I'm thanking my team as well as the HOD of EC, Charlie Rally sir, as well as Vinayal Priya, sorry for that, and the coordinator. So I would like to thank these guys. And the first wholehearted thanks to Meenakshi College of Engineering. So from Chennai, thanks sir, thanks for giving this opportunity. If you have any doubts, please let me know. And please do subscribe for this channel for the next session, as well as we will display all the webinars from this channel itself. So daily we will take 2 webinars. So please follow that one, please gain some knowledge. So firstly, execution is important. Learning is one part and execution is one part. Please go through with execution. We will take care about learning, teaching, okay? Don't worry about any teaching, we will take care about that one. But go through execution, okay? Go through with Tinkercad and all. Please execute that one. Thanks for joining. So thank you. Have a nice day. Please stay at home. Please stay safe. Please wear a mask while going out. And once again, I'm thanking my team to give such an opportunity. From bye Mohan Sai from Pantech E-Learning. I'm signing off. Bye.
So
if you have any doubts, please let me know. I'll end up this session. Yes, yes. Bluetooth module, okay. I'll look into it. I'll ask, we'll arrange that Bluetooth module session too. Don't worry about that one. Thanks for your questions. Thank you. Thank you to Million. Thank you. We are here to give some valuable sessions only. So thanks for joining. So with your permission, I'm ending the session. Thank you.